Hello YouTube, Sarge7 Gaming here with a brand new version of myself, if you like. We're doing a walkthrough, we're doing Mafia 3 walkthrough.
New Bordeaux, a modern city with traditional southern values.
I underestimated how far he was going to go. What he was willing to do.
Visit the historic French Ward and enjoy local cuisine at one of our five-star restaurants.
Killing them wasn't enough. Lincoln Clay was using them to send a message.
Or spend the afternoon in the bayou and take in its natural splendor.
Sal Marcano had no idea what he was going to unleash.
New Bordeaux. Safe. Family-oriented fun. Make it your next vacation destination.
This city survived the War of 1812, the Civil War, and God knows how many hurricanes. But when Lincoln Clay went after the mob, he inflicted more damage than all the wars and hurricanes combined.
As I said, ladies and gentlemen, Sarge7 Gaming, Mafia 3 walkthrough.
Lincoln's mother abandoned him in 1947, a couple of years after he was born. His mother, I heard she was Dominican. I always figured his father was white, maybe even Italian. Not that it mattered. Back then, if you looked black, you black. Same as today, I suppose. He stayed at the orphanage until 1958.
Now, when did you meet Lincoln Clay?
1966. I was running black ops out of Laos on behalf of the CIA. He was loaned out to me via joint CIA-DOD task force.
He was a quiet boy. Good boy.
Two Purple Hearts, a Bronze Star, and the Distinguished Service Cross. He served his country with honor and distinction.
After the city closed the orphanage, he fell in with Sammy Robinson. Sammy ran the black mob over in Delray Hollow. I can't say I approved, but often colored boys didn't have a lot of options back then. Boys like Lincoln, ones who've been abandoned, they're always looking for a home. Always looking for a place to belong. I think he thought he'd find it in the army. Thing is, once that's lost, you can never get it back again. When he returned from the war, Lincoln ended back up over at Sammy's. Now Sammy owed the Italian mob a whole lot of money. And he needed Lincoln's help. It's a damn shame what happened. It breaks my heart.
Say this is the craziest goddamn thing I ever heard. Using real money to rob the feds.
Well, hell, man, not like this is our cash. This all came from Skeletta. Besides, peanuts compared to what we're gonna haul out of there.
Is everything we need to burn?
Yeah, that's it. I grabbed the keys to the truck, then we can get the fuck out of here.
Welcome back, Sarge7 Gaming here. Just have a look around. We're in that door. Okay, let me in then. Ah, that door. No, where's the... Round here. Anyway, how you all guys doing? Hope you're doing well. We thought we'd do something a bit different other than sports.
Hey man, still not sure about leaving him like this.
He came through with the truck just like we asked. Even greased his partner to make it look good. If you got doubts, I'll take the chance.
should get going. You got the keys, so you can drive.
Come on, let's get the hell out of here.
Come on, man. We don't have time for this shit. We need to roll.
Alright, son. Who else is doing it? Let's put the gun away. Anyway, guys, hope you're all doing well. Thought we'd do something new. Mafia 3. Mafia 3 walkthrough. I loved Mafia 2.
Take it easy heading to town. We don't need the cops crawling up our asses.
I absolutely adored it, so.
My old man wanted us to keep one of the guards alive, help throw the feds off the trail.
Like you said, I take a chance. Besides, if I learn anything from being over in Nam, someone's willing to flip sides once, they're probably willing to do it a second time.
Ah!
Fuck you in the process.
I just killed someone.
This was the craziest thing you saw over there.
You don't want to know.
Hell, man, I'm a taxpayer. I got the right to know how my money's being spent.
Oh, Georgie Marcano pays taxes.
Damn right I do. That's how they got Al Capone, and I ain't going to prison for no fucking tax bill. Huh? Come on, you gonna answer the question or what?
We on the coast of Quang Nai, evacuating the civvies for Charlie overran everything. Anyway, we getting him onto a medical ship, and this woman walks up. She got a baby in one hand, and the leash to a pig in the other. She starts up the ramp, and the MP stops her, tells her, you can only bring one thing on board. So she tosses the baby into the water. MP goes ape, tells someone dive in after the kid, starts screaming at the woman, wants to know what the fuck she's thinking. You know what she says to him? She says, I can always have another baby.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Hey man, you asked.
Yeah, but I thought you were gonna tell me a story about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, god damn.
It's not a fault, but not like you think. Conditions over there, man. Jesus Christ. One day you're raising cattle, tending your rice. Next day everything bombed flat. You put people up against the wall, they will do anything to survive.
That better have been one delicious fucking pig.
Anyway, that was, yeah, it's a good story, isn't it? Enjoy your bedtime. Anyway, that's more for you, I suppose. Let's crack on. Let's see if we can get up here without being, like, should we say killing any more people? We killed it. I apologise to that woman. Perfuse, it's my bad. I'll come back and take you to hospital, right? Sorry, we're all good. Should be fine. Just having a little rest. Little rest there. She's fine. What are we doing? We're going straight on still. Going straight on. So, I don't know if I'm going to get done for this, so we're going to turn it down a bit more again. Probably are going to get done, actually. I'm still going straight. Look at this! Is this not GTA 5? Sorry, man. not at least don't I feel like GTA 5. Okay, the random talking. Hate that when they're in the car because you don't know what you're doing. But anyway, I'm probably going to get done for this. Anyway, if we keep talking over the top of it, hopefully it'll be.
Back it up to the loading dock.
Somebody's... Fellas might get a little rough with the language and...
Well, ain't like I never been called nigger before.
I know, but I'm just saying, if I go along with it, ain't nothing personal.
The only thing I care about is getting our hands on that money.
I say something about being hot, that's when we make our move.
All right.
Now, here we go.
Put your IDs up to the glass.
We're part of the Boeing crew.
The fuck's this shit heel doing here?
Affirmative action. You know how it is.
Old country is spinning around a goddamn toilet. You can follow me. As for you, go on and grab those bags off the truck. You'll be carrying them to the burning room. How much y'all bring in?
$238,546. Small bills mostly.
Yeah. It's a good time. It's a good time. I'm not going to be able to walk any faster than this, am I? God damn!
Need to check that scattergun. You packing anything?
Still in training.
Good. One less goddamn thing for me to worry about.
You can pick it up on the way out.
Buying rooms down in the cellar. This way. I ain't seen y'all around these parts before.
Y'all's over in Georgia for a while. He just got out the service.
My cousin's been trying to get on here for over a year now. Was in the Navy for two tours, got medals falling out of his ass. Government tells him thanks, but no thanks.
That's a crock of shit if I ever heard one.
Sad day when a God-fearing white man can't get a job. It ain't your nigga who staggers in his hide on the spot.
Yeah, it's some good shizzle right there. Yeah, some good stuff.
You bastards better not be playing with each other back there.
Fuck you! Christ, look at that. Didn't know y'all held that much gold.
That Washington's been shuffling around on account of the war. It's here, then it gets sent to Dallas, then it comes back. That doesn't make a lick of goddamn sense. Here we are. Put those bags on the table there.
Never done this detail before. Figured it'd be bigger.
That gets the job done. Only time there's a problem is when the flue clogs up.
Fuck. That's some heat right there.
Used to use coal for it, but here's so.
God, that guy was an asshole.
We need to move. Danny and Ellis should be coming up any time now.
Right, give me a second. Take care of those guards. Keep your ass down. You don't want them getting a drop on us.
I know what the fuck I'm doing.
You know that house we've been renting out? Called over there last night. Told them I wanted to sell it. Told them they'd have to be out in 2 weeks. The man, his name's, John, starts laying into me, saying the lease gives them the right to a 30-day notice. That's how he's supposed to find a new place in 2 weeks. So I tell him none of that's my goddamn problem. It's my property. And come on, we need to get this vault open.
That was fun. Get it.
Oh, I hope this domination stiletto goddess is legit.
Woo! Kicking some ass.
Well, I'll be damned. All right, go for it, Godzilla.
Thank you.
to take care of this room. You see what you can get from outside. Once these boys punch through with that drill, we're going to start throwing this down.
Yeah, so this is, this is some shit. How bad is that from?
Shit, I didn't notice this cage was on a different system. Alright, we're gonna hold off the guards until Danny's done drilling.
Alright.
Hey.
Let's start shooting. We in here. Let's start going. Wasting some bullets there, man. Oh, headshot! Oh, there we go. Crunch.
We shall kick the hornet's nest this time.
Only way we walk out of here is if we get the weapon stored in that armory. Bust the door open. I'll watch our asses.
My old man gonna shit a brick when he hears about this. Fuck! Come on, open!
Right. We gotta do this. Not really. It smells a lot. Rotate out into the green zone, then press X. Okay.
Close to the vault, watch for the drill. I'll deal with these assholes.
What? Guys, a suspect on the move! Find a cover!
Well, Sammy had men all over the place.
Now, one of the cleaners
and stole the uniforms Georgie Marcano and Lincoln Clay wore on the day of the robbery. Another one was a janitor at the Federal Reserve, and he provided a rough layout. The robbery of the Federal Reserve was timed perfectly, and none of it would have been possible without the involvement of Sammy Robinson, Lincoln Clay, and the rest of the black mob.
You just come from Vietnam?
That's right.
I was a Marine in the Pacific. You can take it from me. Just because you're home doesn't mean you're back. You understand? People around here, they don't get it. Never will. Keep your ass out of trouble.
I'm late. Got caught up crossing the bridge.
Don't worry about it.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for my stepbrother, Lincoln Clay. You seen him? He used to get ticked off if you were even a minute late.
Kiss my ass.
There he is. How was the trip?
Being as how this is the first time in 4 years and somebody telling me where to go, what to do, or how to do it, it was fucking great. What's new with the old man?
Man, don't even get me started on Pops. He used to pull his head out of his ass.
Same as ever then.
Brother, you have no fucking idea.
Damn, Ellis. She's looking good. Just like I left her.
Man, even I know not to fuck around with your cop.
All right, come on. I'm ready to go home. Sammy's doing all right.
Ever since we got your telegram about coming home, he's been climbing the walls. What if the plane crashes? What if the train's delayed? What if they call him back? And he goes stand in front of the kitchen window and sip his whiskey like he was expecting you come strolling up the sidewalk. Don't say nothing about me telling you that.
I won't.
He'll be fine once he sees you. Ever since Mama Hell, you know how he gets.
Let's get used to driving these older cars. They ain't gonna handle like new cars. You already see that. No policeman. Right, there's yep.
You remember Marty and Ron Langford? They moved up to Empire Bay a year or so after you shipped out. Started selling weed. They call and ask me if I want some. I say, sure. It's free money as far as I'm concerned. Anyhow, a month back, Marty drops me a line and says they're moving into heroin, that they're looking for a partner down around these parts.
Can't imagine Sammy was too keen on that.
I never told him about the weed. That ain't nothing to nobody. But this, I gotta talk to him about. I ain't said more than 3 words and he's yelling about the feds. How we don't need J. Edgar up our asses and what the fuck am I thinking? Selling dope with kids running around the neighborhood. We ain't selling no dope to no children.
Like they got any money to begin with. Fucking around aside, that was pretty serious shit. Knew a couple guys over in Nam who were running it. Wound up pissing off the wrong person. Got their throats cut.
Shit, man, I know what's what. That's why I'm talking to Georgie about it.
There's no way Sal's gonna go along with that.
Georgie says he can keep his old man from fighting out. We'll steer clear of the high-low in Frisco, just selling the French Wall. Georgie's Uncle Lou won't say shit as long as we give him a taste of the action.
I don't know, man. Georgie's a cool cat and all, but heroin ain't the kiddie pool.
Come in on it with us. I bet he'd agree to a three-way split.
I don't know. I kinda need to lay low a bit, figure some things out.
Yeah, all right. Once you get settled in, I was thinking we could go to this new club in the French Ward. Maybe double date it.
Well, who the hell am I gonna go with? Your great Aunt Beatrice?
Oh, God. I ever tell you I accidentally saw her without a shirt once?
Oof.
That woman has the droopiest, nastiest tits I've ever seen. They were like 2 sacks of potatoes with nothing in them.
Yeah, like that was a fucking accident.
Hey, man, fuck you. I was damn lucky to walk away from that one. Anyway, you'll go with Regine.
Regine?
Believe me, once you see her, you're gonna want to dig right in.
Matter of fact,
she got half the guys in the hollow sniffing around asking her out. Turns them all down. She's only got eyes for you, Lincoln Clay.
Fuck you.
Wait and see, man. One look and your pecker's gonna pop right out.
Dirty bastards. Fair play, though. Enjoy that shit if you can. Some speed up. Who's fucking parked here, man?
found panhandling out in front of the train station.
Pleasure, man.
Back, baby. Boy, I send you to bring Lincoln Clay home. Not the big nigga who ate him.
Well, shit, old man. I finally went somewhere they knew how to cook.
Welcome home, son. How are you?
I'll be better once I get some of that shine in me.
I always did love corn whiskey. I would like to make a toast. My father used to say that the real worth of a man came from the mark he left on the world. When Lincoln first told me he was joining the military, I was against it. Too dangerous, I say. Let those people fight their own war, I say. But then I realized Lincoln needed to go out and make his mark. And that's precisely what he did. I'm so, so proud of you. Pour Lincoln! Bienvenue à la maison!
Pour Lincoln! Bienvenue à la maison!
Good to see you.
You look so good.
Nice seeing you, Lincoln. Oh, I kept you in my prayers.
I really appreciate that, Father.
Now who wants to get shit-faced? Woo!
It's hard to explain what it's like coming home from war. Elation. Fear. Guilt. Imagine being trapped in a dark room and there's no way out. And every fear, every nightmare you ever had is in that room with you. And there's no escape from any of it. And then, one day, a door opens, and you're free to go. Just like that. The thing is, you made your peace with your terror and your fear of death. And now part of you is afraid to leave it behind. But what choice do you have? Every soldier has to walk through that door. One way or another.
Man, whiskey's going hoy in the morning.
Hell, man, just sleep it off. The room's the same as you left it.
I'm gonna take the basement.
The basement? Why the fuck you wanna crash down there?
I'll see you in the morning.
Man, that wall must have really fucked you up.
Oh, would you want to sleep in a basement? Must be something to do with the old war, I suppose. Let's just see, what? We got anything in here? Have a quick mooch around? Is this in here? Yeah, I don't know what that was. Any little collectible? Any little trophy? I don't think there is there? My bad. Nope. Fargo's painting, 1 in 4 in Delray Hollow. Okay, found the paintings as well. Oh, Playboy. Basically, we're going for another Playboys under the hut ladies. Okay! Okay, let's go and talk to him.
We barely have two nickels to rub together. Now we're paying for all that food. Jesus Christ.
Watch that mouth of yours.
We wouldn't be in this mess if you would have listened to me.
What mess?
Not something you need to worry about, Linka. I got it under control.
Under control? God damn it, you need
to... Boy, I'm not warning you again.
Have it your way, old man.
Let him be. He needs to cool off.
You mind telling me what's got him so riled up?
We've been having problems with the Haitians. But like I say, I got it under control.
Well, truck's all loaded up. I figure we got enough out there for... Should I come back?
In honor of your returning to us safe and sound, I made a donation to Father James here. Supplied him with food he can hand out to some of our needier family.
I was hoping you'd lend me a hand, Lincoln, and give you a chance to see the neighborhood.
This thing with the Haitians, how serious is it?
Ah, you know Ellis. Someone looks at him the wrong way, he's on them like a wet dog.
Like I said, I can come back.
Nonsense. Lincoln needs to get out. Enjoy the day. Besides, be good for the two of you to spend some time together. Go on. Those people waiting on their food.
Oh, I saw Langan a couple times once he was first back. He told me he wanted to leave town, head out to California. Now, he had a friend in the service who could get him a job working at the Mare Island shipyard. And the only reason he came back was to tell Sammy and Ellis goodbye. But then he found out about the trouble Sammy was having with those Haitians. So he decided to stay and help. Those Haitians, they are bad news. No talking Lincoln out of it. Whatever else he might have become, Lincoln was always loyal.
Most likely. 3-month apprenticeship to start, then the union lets you in.
You tell Sammy and Ellis?
Not yet. Gonna wait a few days. Didn't want to spring it on them since I just got back.
Well, they won't like to hear it, but they'll come around. You need to do what's best for you. Go ahead and start serving those folks. I'll be back.
All right. Let's give some people some dinner.
Give Sammy my best, Lincoln.
Yes, sir.
Warm meal, warm heart, for sure.
Oh, I should do it.
Thanks.
My bad.
Good morning.
Morning.
You delivering a real blessing here, Lincoln. Thank you.
Well, thank you.
My bad. Couple days back and they already got you working?
I'm happy to do it.
Means a hell of a lot to all of us.
Thank you. You're gonna say it. Mm-hmm.
It's a fucking shit show.
I'll see what I can do about that.
Hey there, Lincoln.
How are you, Regine?
I'm good. Nice to see you around the holler again.
Nice to see those big brown eyes again.
Well, they'll be over at my aunt's place with the rest of me. You should stop by.
Maybe I'll do that.
Lincoln, we got trouble.
Run, Regine.
What's going on with you, Lincoln? Sammy's next.
You, man! Rock bottom him!
Francois Papadoc Duvalier was elected president of Haiti in 1957. By 1959, he had created a secret police called Tonton Macoute, and people started to flee. Most of them settled in the southern United States. Mixed in with the good, hard-working people were hardened criminals. They formed the backbone of what became the Haitian gang. Now, Lincoln found out they set up in the swamps and were led by a man named Baca.
You and Father James done already?
We got jumped by the Haitians. It's time you level with me. Tell me what's really going on.
Yes. I suppose it is. Seven months ago, folks in the Hollow started getting robbed. Money, jewelry, things of that nature. Didn't take long for us to figure out it was the Haitians. Then those batas on Velour started going after the lottery.
How much money are we talking about? How much?
Enough that we're in deep shit with Sal Marcano. Haven't kicked up to him in 3 months.
Jesus Christ. If I deal with them, that gives us time to settle up with Marcano, right?
Let me worry about Sal. He and I go way back. But this thing with the Haitians, it's time for it to end. You and Ellis need to handle it.
How are we gonna find them?
Back in the 20s, folks used to pull salt out of the bayou. They built themselves a little shanty town. When the Depression hit, they abandoned it. That's the only place this could have come from.
Gonna need guns and ammo.
Call this number. But do it away from here. No sense tipping anybody off.
Or we could sweep the Hollow, track down and kill every last one of those cocksuckers, then we wouldn't have to worry about it.
The last thing folks in this neighborhood need to see is colored people killing each other. Do this quiet. Away from here.
Once we eliminate whoever's running the show, the rest of them will go down on their own. Trust me.
All right, soldier boy. I'll follow your lead.
Be careful, yeah? Those Haitians are a hard people. Do not ever underestimate them. Celui qui sait diverses sait suscite hostilité.
There you go. That's the end of episode 1 of the Mafia 3. Hit that like button, big thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you're new to it. See you next time. Bye.